Hey guys, welcome back to ETLQL Apps. In this session, we will look at keys in SQL. So currently, we are covering constraints in SQL. So before this video, we have looked at the four different constraints, which are not null, check constraint, unique key constraint, and default constraint. Yeah, those four different constraints we have seen in the previous video. Now in continuation with that, the keys are also part of constraints. Yeah, so constraints as part of constraints. So we have how many keys we have got? We have got candidate key, primary key, alternate key, composite key, and there is one more that is called foreign key, right? So foreign key we are not covering here because the session will be lengthy, so I will cover that as part of a separate session. But in this session, we will try to understand these different four different type of keys in SQL. Okay, and believe me, these keys are very important. Wherever you go for interview, they will definitely ask the questions related to the keys. Yeah, so let's start then and try to understand, right? So first, by definition, what is candidate key? So candidate key is basically it is set of key, set of keys. And each of these keys should be uniquely identify the rows in a particular table, right? So in this case, if you see, I have said that I have made that employee number, passport number, and driving license number. These three are the candidate keys. They are individually a candidate key, which means these three keys are able to distinguish each and every record in the table, right? So for example, employee number, this is always unique, right? So by definition, the candidate key should have the property of unique, right? So it should have the unique constraint on that particular column. So in this case, driving license number, it is unique and it is able to distinguish the entire record. Okay, passport number is also same, passport number is also unique, and the passport number cannot be, cannot be same for two people. Okay, even across the country it will be different, right? Now employee number, obviously employee number is always, organization will provide this number, and it is always unique and it is also not null, right? So this is the candidate key. So candidate key, the by definition, the candidate key should have the unique values, right? So this is the candidate key. Now what we will do is we will see that, what are the candidate keys which can be the primary key. So one of the key from this candidate key, in this case we have these three, right? So one of the keys can be made as a primary key. So in this case, we have made employee number as a primary key. And then what will happen? Immediately, other two candidate keys will be called as alternate key, because we have already chosen a primary key, and then other will be already called as alternate key, right? But if you look at this, these are the alternate key is also a same set of, the subset of the candidate key only. So this is also having the same property, because this is the same keys, right? Same columns actually coming here. Only thing is, after selecting the primary key from one of the keys from this candidate key, other remaining column will become the alternate key, right? So this is a concept, right? We will look at why primary key we have chosen. Why we have chosen this one of them a primary key, right? So you can actually choose any one of the candidate key as a primary key, okay? Because they are self-sufficient to uniquely identify each record. So you have to see the most appropriate, right? So in this case, in this is the employee table, and the information regarding employee is there. Is there available in this? So it is important that we choose a key which is unique, number one, and number two is it is not null, which means that particular field is mandatory, cannot be left blank, right? So employee number cannot be left blank, because when employee joins, the employee will get one employee ID for him, right? So every employee will get one employee unique, right? So by default it is unique here as part of candidate key, but when you make a primary key, it should be not null also, right? Whereas other two columns, for example, passport number and driving license, they are unique, no doubt about it, but they cannot be, all the time not null. There is possibility that employee do not have the passport number. In that case, it can be left blank also. This can also be left blank, right? That is the reason I have chosen this as a primary key, okay? So any one key from the candidate key can be chosen as a primary key, and then remaining keys or remaining columns will be the alternate key. Okay, hope this definition is making sense, right? So candidate key and alternate key, these are mostly in definition. We are not going to we cannot define them as a candidate key and alternate key. This is mostly definition. Only constraint that we can put is the unique constraint, right, when we create the table. But primary key, there is a constraint that we can put, right? So that is the constraint, primary key constraint, okay, that we will see how apply that while creating a table. Now the fourth one is the composite key, right? So composite key is basically again key, and the characteristic should be very similar to what alternate key or candidate key is having. It should be unique only. It should have the unique characteristics, okay? Until this composite key is made primary key, it doesn't need to have the not null constraint, okay, on this particular key. But one by definition, you see composite is more than one, correct? So basically this key or this particular key is made of more than one column, combination of more than one column, when apply these two columns together, and then only it will be able to identify each and every records uniquely. That's why it is called composite key. Now in this case, if you see that, right, we will see the composite key in this case. Now we have the passport number. This is always unique to the country, all the countries, right? So all the country will have the uniquely. So it can be distinguished at the country level. Now the driving license, so driving license number can not really be unique across the globe, right? I mean, for example, let's say I have something like this 1 2 3 4 5 6 5 6 6 7, something like this, and then this same driving license, I mean, maybe, other countries also apply the same thing, yeah? Maybe this also, instead of this, right? The UK having the same driving license, Germany country also having the same driving license number. This is quite possible because these driving license are actually distinguished within the country, not on, outside country, right? So this is quite possible. Now, this driving license is no more a candidate key because it cannot really distinguish the entire record in a table, because this one and these two are in this case are not unique, right? In that case, what will happen is we have to take the country also into consideration, right? So country plus driving license, if we actually making these two together, right, and making a key defining these two as a unique, then this will called as a composite key. Okay, guys, so I hope you understand this composite key concept. When one of the column, when we are using multiple columns to make a unique value on that particular combination of that column, and that is called the composite key. I hope that is you are able to understand it. Now we will see quickly the practical implementation, okay, and we will see that how it works, okay. Now let's, I have already, kept it ready so that, it will be easy for us to just run the query and see that, okay? I'm just creating. So table created. Now I will just show you. So create table EMP employee number, and then I have given the column, the data type and the size. And then I have also defined the primary key to this particular column, okay? And then employee name, there is no constraint here. Work location, no constraint. Country, there is no constraint here. Passport number, okay? Passport number, I have defined a constraint called unique constraint, okay? And then license number, also unique constraint in this case. Now, why? Because they are the candidate key, right? They need to be unique. Now, let's see the descriptor. let's see the table structure after created. So see, this is saying that not null, right? Not null means we have defined this as a primary key. That's why it is not null and also unique. All right, these two are unique. Okay, now let's try to insert some record, and then we will see that, you know, how the primary key is restricting. All right guys, so let's quickly insert the records. All right, so let's go record one inserted, record number two, okay, record number three. I'm just inserting three records now. One second guys, I think the name of this country is little longer. Okay, I'll just trim it. Okay, now it is done. Now if we see, just say select star from EMP, we will see employee number is always unique here, because that should be unique, and this passport numbers are also unique. See guys, unique, and then diving license is also unique. Now what we'll try to see is, we will try to see what if we are inserting the employee number. We are not inserting employee number, which means we are actually putting the empty value or the null value, whether it is accepting or not, right? So I have already created a record now. See, employee number with null value, okay, which means we are actually not inserting anything into employee field, okay, employee number, okay. So it should actually give you error. It's sorry guys, I think let me one second, let me go there and okay, driving license. Okay, I don't want driving okay, 2, 3 should be okay. Let me try, why it's giving you error. Let's try. Okay, got it. I think some name is a problem here. Okay, here the name of the column was wrong. Okay, now let's try. Inserted, no inserted, not inserted. It is giving a proper error here. Okay, what is the error? Because we are actually not inserting the employee number, we are actually inserting directly from employee name, which means we have skipped already employee number, which means we are trying to insert the null value into employee number field, and it will not allow, because it is saying cannot insert null into system EMP number. Employee number cannot have a null value because it is a primary key, right? And by definition primary key should be not null and unique. Now null value, we try to see that it is enforcing you to insert some value. It cannot be left blank or it cannot be left empty. Now second one is, we will try to insert some duplicate record. So guys, we have already inserted, so this is already the record already present, 100, right, 1000, employee number 1000. Now what if we will try to insert again? It should not take, because it should be unique, right? But employee number 100 is already there, which is not unique. So now it is giving you unique key constraint violated, right? Because we are again trying to insert 1000, which is already there in the table before, right? So this is the two property, that is for the unique, for the primary key, it should be unique and not null. And this we have seen practically, how if we are trying to insert something which is, not expected, and then you will not be able to do it, and you will get the error. Okay, now we will also try to see the candidate key. We will try to see whether, you know, we are able to insert the passport number which is duplicate, right? Because candidate keys should be duplicate, right? Should not be duplicate, right? They should be always unique as per definition, right? So let's try to see this one example. Alternate key with duplicate. Okay, so what I'm trying to do is, I'm just trying to insert the passport number. So passport number is 102123, ending with 23. I think this should already be there, right? So 23, this one is already there, right? So which means we will not be able to insert that. Okay, even if we try, we will not be able to insert that, because this passport number field is actually, yes, it is saying unique key constraint, because this particular passport number is already existing, and then it is not unique, and we have defined as a unique to that because that is a candidate key. All right, guys, so this is what I wanted to, you know, cover as part of this session, and hope this is really clearing your doubts or your concern on candidate key, primary key, alternate key, and composite key. Okay, now one of the question that interviewer can ask is, you know, how many primary key you can define on a particular table, right? So the answer is, we can define only one primary key on the entire table, okay? Because if a single key or single column, which is made as a primary key, can ensure the uniqueness in the entire record, why do we need more than one, right? So that is the very logical. So that is the reason Oracle does not allow you to define multiple primary key. So you can define only one primary key on a particular table, and that primary key can be on a single column, or it can also be on a composite key, right? So that particular primary key can be defined on a composite key also. Like, you can combine two columns and you can make that as a primary key, right? Now, second question is, how many unique keys, or some people called as a unique key, right? Unique key you can define. So unique key can be, you know, multiple unique key you can define. So any columns, any of the columns in the field, everything can be defined as a unique key, right? So that will ensure that you will not be able to insert the duplicate value on those particular keys, right? But we don't need to define everything as a unique, because there will be, you know, logical business that we, for example, country cannot be unique because you might need to have multiple records for the same country, right? So you cannot define this as a unique key. Otherwise, you will be able to enter only one single, you know, value. So this is what I wanted to discuss about the keys. And you know, guys, this is very important to understand the keys. And in the next session, I will explain about the foreign key. And then after that, we will conclude our constraints in SQL. Okay. So hope this session is fruitful and you are able to understand it. If you still have some doubt or some questions, please do comment on this video. I will be able to come back to you as soon as possible. And guys, if you have not subscribed my video, means channel, please do subscribe it. Do consider to subscribe it, because I am putting efforts to, you know, making this video free for you. And I am actually covering, you know, from starting until, you know, you can get the overall confidence, you know, in SQL, right? So that is the reason I think I will not skip any topic which is, you know, which is important. So I'll try to cover each and everything. So this is all I wanted to talk about in this session, guys. Thank you very much, and continue watching my other videos also, and try to watch from, you know, starting until end. That's when you will be able to understand entire context of SQL, right? And anyways, I'm covering in detail this particular series. So continue watching, and you know, we'll come back with the next video next time. Until then, happy learning, guys. Thank you for watching. Bye.